Hi everyone, I'm Paula Stewart and I'm the Brand Director, and I'm delighted to introduce the Christmas campaign, Sparkle at Night. We really wanted to bring Christmas to life for you so that you could really get a true feel for the fantastic activities we've put into place to have a really successful and fun time on the run up to Christmas. We want to empower you with as much knowledge so you can deliver a fantastic Christmas experience to our customer. Last year saw some amazing record-breaking sales, which means we have a really big job to do and we need to focus on driving full price sales. The collection this year is well balanced between day wear and evening wear, and the Christmas range is much more focused on jersey item dressing, therefore better price points and more bar wear focused. In a minute, Lisa Byrne, our design director, will take you through some of her key Christmas looks, how to wear and what to wear. Caroline will then tell you about the exciting activities she has planned to engage and excite our customer. Louisa and the VM team will bring to life the collection through her inspired VM and unveil our cool urban Christmas windows. And finally, Rachel will share some words of wisdom. So that's really all I've got to say. I'm sure you're as excited about Christmas as I am. So please go, have fun, enjoy yourselves and sparkle. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Lisa Byrne. I'm the Design Director at Warehouse. And today we're going to talk to you about the Christmas trend overview and the key pieces for the party season. So our first look is Cocktail Hour. And it's quite a sort of atelier debutante 50s chic glamorous look for the season. And Vanessa here is wearing a look I've put together, which is our beautiful embellished white beaded skater dress on soft grey, and our cocoon coat from our transition story cloud. So skater dresses are one of the key silhouettes for the season. We love this silhouette, it's quite short on the length. But quite knitting at the waist. We also have in the look long pencil slim skirts and crop tops being quite key. The skinny trouser worn with the shirt, maybe with the embellished collar. It's quite a glamorous, sexy, feminine look for the season. As well as this beautiful embellished skater dress, also key to the look is the long pencil slim silhouette as well, maybe one with the crop top. This pencil skirt and crop top combination with the organza panelling is beautiful, so this is due in soon. And also key to the look is this beautiful crystal neckline, pale blue silk top with the elasticated waist, and this A-line quilted skirt, so it quite modernises the look, so it's not strictly a 50s reference. Okay, so this is our second look, and just to talk about the trend for the season, which is huge, which is 80s, always one of my favourites, and this look spans across a few different types. So there's a huge emphasis towards that of the rock chick look, but also the 80s empowered glamorous look too. We're really key for this look as well is we're really keen on these all-in-ones. So we've already seen some playsuits and all-in-ones. You've had the big shoulder pad ones. This one is the printed playsuit, which we adore, and I've teamed it here with the yellow leather belt just to give it that added pop of colour and the heel. And also the biker jacket, and this is your key volume biker jacket for the season with the quilting and the gold zips, very Versace. So talking about the pops of colour that we use throughout this look, it's quite a lot of black and white. We also love the pink scratchy print 80s cami that we've got over there on the mannequin with the leatherette leggings, and then the bright pink crepe dress. So it does cross over from day wear to sort of going out as well. So we talked about our 80s glamour look. This is our epitome of glamour, our embellished shoulder bodycon dress. Vanessa just came out of a changing room with it on the wrong way round, and she looked amazing in it because it's got this beautiful low back detail with the embellishment, so it could be more matchful. So this is our bodycon dress. We also have our Lurex jersey shoulder pad dress, which is also all store, and our tuxedo jacket, which you team up as one outfit. And we see the return of our boned corset with the deep plunging V, and this is our tailored boned corset, and I've teamed it today with our peg trouser in crepe, so it's a bit of a matching outfit. This is kind of like our sophisticated nightclub outfit. And then if you put the jacket on, Vanessa, we've got this great leather and lace fringe trimmed jacket I'm actually wearing it myself. It's one of my favourite key pieces. lovely. We don't do the no coat policy at Warehouse, and for this look I've pulled out the black glossy fur jacket, which is key for the season, in this beautiful glossy cut fur. So another new look that we've got for the season is Empress and Ornate Baroque. We've combined the two. And what's really key for this is these beautiful ornate jacquards. And the way we've done it for this is the new Coord set. So we're calling it Coord. You'll hear that buzzword a lot, even through into next spring and summer. And we've got our black and gold one with the embellished jewelled neckline. So it's almost, the embellishment here is almost replacing the jewellery, if you like. What's quite key for this look as well is the beautiful ornate baroque patterning on the jacquards, and actually wearing the two pieces together so they almost clash. Also key is not revealing an awful lot of your body, so everything's quite high-necked. And it's got quite historical references, this, if any of you have watched the Game of Thrones. This is sort of quite inspired, the whole look is quite inspired by this. So also key to the look is the statement jean and trouser. So you'll be getting delivered into store quite a lot of jacquard jeans, and also leather and lace mixed together.
Hi guys, my name's Caroline Bradley and I'm Head of Marketing for Warehouse. I'm here to tell you all about our exciting Christmas concept. So what are the objectives for Christmas? So they haven't changed at all. So our objectives are to drive awareness around the ambitious stylist, to activate our urban city stores, to build a multi-channel campaign, but also to build really high levels of buzz and excitement around each and every concept. So this season we've worked with Brooklyn Brothers. So this is all about everything she gets up to during the Christmas period. So starting in the morning with the white Christmas look, we've got the minus 10 degrees look, we've also got 10 minutes to a closing look when she's running to get her Christmas presents. So there's 7 in total, and you would have all received them in your pack by now. So we've teamed up with Tony and Guy and beauty brand Bare Minerals to create how-to videos showing customers how to bring each look to life. As an extra layer for this, we've actually teamed with some really, really cool bloggers. So we found 7 bloggers to be our models for each how-to video. What this means to us is that we've given them something that really resonates with the customer, it has a sense of reality, but above and beyond that, it gives us an additional reach out to their audience. Okay, so how are we going to roll it out? So we've taken a 3-tier approach to make sure that everybody gets a piece of the Christmas magic. So tier 1 are our urban city stores, you know who you are. So for you, we're doing in-store events to drive awareness and the halo effect around each metropolis. Tier 2 is about all the other solas. So all of the solas, as we did with Stummy, if you can, you're going to have usherette trays, and you're also going to be giving out chocolate bars, and those chocolate bars will drive people in store. And it's your opportunity as well to talk around the campaign. So everybody else will get a postcard pack. So all other solas will get a postcard pack. So this is a beautifully designed postcard pack that features campaign imagery, blogger information, and most excitingly, it's augmented. So you'll be able to see, scan, watch with the customer and drive them to our exciting online hub. Once she's on the online hub, she'll be able to see all of the activity that we're doing around Christmas, advertising events, talking about product, talking about the how-to videos, so she'll get a piece of Urban City Store events even though she's not there. We're also launching a really exciting competition nationwide on Instagram that's about uploading your Christmas party look, so please encourage customers to do that. Once they've uploaded their look, they'll win the opportunity to have their look illustrated and made into a Christmas card pack. So it's a really exciting competition and one we hope that you love too.
Hi, I'm V Vic. I'm the visual and creative coordinator for Central London. This year, we've really tried to make sure that our Christmas windows are really on brand, and we've really gone back to our brand heritage by making them urban, raw, and edgy. With the mannequin outfits, we've really focused on key kind of pieces. So leather has played a massive role with this. For rock style prints, embellishment, fur, and lace. We've also done a navy, grey, and black colour palette.
Hi, my name's Sarah and I'm the BM project coordinator for Warehouse. Further down the chain, we have Spread the Sparkle at Night with our Christmas windows. From previous feedback, stores have told us how it's really tricky to install these decals. So here I'm going to demonstrate how to install a fret cut decal. The three main things you need to use when installing a decal is squeegee, scissors, and some sellotape. So first of all, put sellotape all along the corner of the decal. Okay, you just need to make sure that there are no gaps whilst applying the sellotape, and then once you put the decal on the window, make it ensuring that it's straight. Because this is quite a large decal, what you want to do is actually cut up the letters to make sure so you can do it more accurately. Make sure you cut up past the tape, but to not actually cut the tape that's applied to the window. Make sure that the tape is still secure at the top and that you're able to move the decal up and down, because what you want to do is peel the backing paper. So next step is to use squeegee and then start to peel back the backing paper. Be careful that the letters don't transfer on the backing paper. And then push down the letters onto the window, like so. You need to make sure that you're really, really careful and that you're squeegeeing out all those bubbles. The thinner letters are going to be slightly more trickier to do, so make sure you take your time whilst doing this. Always do like a once over with the squeegee, just to double check you haven't got any bubbles and no creases. And then all you need to do is to repeat throughout the decal. So after you've applied the decal, just go over with a once over the squeegee just to make sure that there are no bubbles, no creases, and that it's all applied perfectly smooth on. And then now, it's the fun bit, just carefully peel the paper off, and then you should reveal a lovely gold Sparkle at Night decal. So make sure that you're peeling it really, really slowly, because these letters do have a tendency, if they're not stuck on properly, it will come off the backing paper. If that does happen, don't panic. Just go back over, just apply it back to the window and use the squeegee again, and then it should go on nicely. You may have noticed that I've applied this decal inside. This is purely purpose for the video. Make sure when you're setting up your Christmas windows that you're applying a decal outside the window. I hope you find this useful.
Hi, I'm Louisa Butler, the VM manager for Warehouse. Welcome to our Christmas seasonal setup video. I'm going to talk you through the visual priorities that we'll want you to action over the Christmas period. The key priorities are driving densities whilst making sure the product's more visible, balancing colour throughout the shop floor, destination areas, and then mannequin groupings and bar configurations. The key changes for this seasonal setup are bar configurations. We still have an A and B bar configuration, however, we've looked at where we can drive density while still having more product faced out. So you'll see an increased use of T bars and step arms. We've also updated our mannequin configurations, so where we would have had a large group of mannequins at the front of store and back, this has now moved on. We've now got mannequins to groups of three. You can increase this to groups of four if you're a larger store, with the rails placed behind them, so it's very much about see it, buy it, and the product that's on the mannequins can be shopped from the product that's on the floor fixture behind. As a brand, it's important to us that we're ensuring that our standards are consistent across the shop floor. So it's really important that we're making sure the product is sized, steamed, finger spaced, that it's neat and tidy on the shop floor, and that any folded product is folded neatly and in size order. Pastels are big this season. We've pulled together a new theme called Cloud, which is on the right-hand side of the store. It's based around a colour palette of blues, mints and creams. We've added in leather just to give it that edgier feel and create outfits throughout the wall. We have created a key look to Cloud using the light blue pastel as a repeat colour through the mannequins, and again highlighted by using leather pieces such as pelmet skirts and pencil skirts, and then accessorising with leather handbags. Destination areas that are key for us are knitwear, cold weather, outerwear, denim and lifestyle. We've updated our theme Empress so that we've taken the teal colourway from it, and then we're left with a colour palette of navy, white and black. The key pieces are based around embellishment, lace, Baroque style prints, and then we just need to make sure that we're spreading the navy throughout the wall and making sure the embellished pieces are front faced. We've also updated our torso positioning so that they're positioned on an angle, and we've got one turned the other way to show the back detail of some of our product. Our leading statement is gold and black Baroque. We've added in black knitwear, PU jackets and jeans. Ensure that you're making the product on the table outfit built. For stores that don't have the wooden tier of the table, you would just lead in with three two-ways that are front-faced. We've built a four-way around lurex and added in key pieces of outerwear. We've also created a key statement in one of our rooms based on teal and black with Baroque prints. Avalon has now become floor-based, and we've picked key pieces to dress on our mannequin key look. Adjacent to this, we've built our tuxedo statement where we've kept the bar configuration simple and clean. Within our tuxedo statement, we've added in clutches and key statement necklaces. Knitwear destination is still a priority for us as a business, so we've made sure that we've given it key focus by merchandising it on the table. The colour palette is blackberry and cream, and we've ensured that we've added in cold weather and that we've merchandised this on the table going wall to floor. Our third key look is based around outerwear and knitwear, and we've sat there adjacent to our destination areas of knitwear, outerwear and denim. We've built tailoring in a wall, we've kept the colour palette really clean and simple, and we've added lace detail and textured pieces to create interest. We have a new theme called Frankie. The colour palette is white, grey, black with highlights of fuchsia pink. It's a strong theme with 80s influence. The key pieces within this theme are check, we've got prints, we've got product with detail on, so we need to ensure that we're balancing this throughout the rails. We've opted to have this theme on the back wall because it's a really bright colour to draw the customer towards the back of store. We've added in coordinating accessories, so jewellery that picks up the colour fuchsia, and also we've added in clutch bags that are relevant with the product. Both British Wilds and Animal Print Statement have now become floor-based. Coat destinations can be built on the wall or they can be built floor-based. They're a really good product to use when you want to split the long wall. For our Spotlight collection, we've built a dress statement wall-based, and the colour palette has been split, so we've got berry, navy and black. The remaining dresses are built floor-based, but we've incorporated leather and PU jackets to just make it feel that a little bit more outfit built.
So now you do you feel ready for Christmas? We really hope this film has given you a great insight into the things that we need you to drive in store for the next critical 8 weeks. We hope you've got a better understanding around product, around the fantastic marketing campaign, and around the VM layout that we really need to drive sales in store. It's such a key 8 week for us in retail. We need to take 20% of our whole year's money just in the next 8 weeks.
And if you want you to do one thing, it's to put the customer first at everything that you do. So whether that's great VM, so it's easy for it to shop, great operations, so she can find what she wants, when she wants it, and above all, give an amazing experience in your stores.
Have a very Merry Christmas and sparkle at night.